Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon, as per usual. We're just jumping in here. We have a cave, which if I recall correctly, there's a Nyx Hound problem, so... Okay. Also... trees, apparently. Alright. Who are we looking for here? We are looking for Novor Drethin. And he is none of these people.
You may speak.
There you are. Greetings, are you here to help? We've been having some problems here in the mines. A pack of Nyx hounds was attacking my miners. We thought one of the miners was lost at first, but she turned up safe. Our healers, Terras, won't go back down to... the words are hard. Our healer went down to look for her and hasn't come back. Would you go back down into the mines and bring her back if she still lives? He still lives, rather. I would go myself, but I should stay here to protect the miner if the Nyx Hounds come back this way. There's a pack, huh? Bunch of them loose in the mine, causing all sorts of trouble. Okay. I can handle Nyx Hounds, I think. This should be within the realm of critter beasts that I can kill if I can, you know, not get stuck on terrain. We just have to find out how deep in they are. Oh, hey, there's one. There's another. There's Nyx Hounds everywhere! They're coming out of the walls! Jesus. Alright. So we're looking for the healer, and I'm just gonna kind of like kill every Nyx Hound we find. Alright, so that just looped us around, so we actually, I think, want to go this way. Down this hall, so technically we're not going deeper into the mines literally, because we're going up, but figuratively it is deeper into the mine because it is further away from the entrance. Hey, we found the dune. Did Novar send you? Let's travel together back to the entrance. Alright. Follow me. Guide me back so he knows I'm safe. Sure, this is gonna go swimmingly with your incredibly good pathing AI. I'm gonna take the long way. I don't trust him to try and handle that little bendy path there because the AI in this game is suspect at best. Come on. Come on. Steering with the mini-map. Alright, let's get out of here. Come on, almost there. Oh, we're gonna have to navigate him past a few NPCs. Uh-oh. Oh, that's the first one down. The guard's moving, though, that makes it harder.
I only have a few moments.
Come on.
Thank you.
Alright. Hey. Alright, we must get him back and then restore order. Alright. So knowing that, we are gonna go do violence. Get out of my way, dude! Jesus. I know it breaks immersion to be able to walk through NPCs, but... sometimes it is nice. Alright, let's see what we have back here. Is this it? No, I think there's another passage back here. Alright. I'm gonna say, like, it seems like we've killed everything what needs killing. According to the map, it looks like there's a path here. But it might just be... Nah, I think it's just this little niche. Alright, so apparently we are done. Maybe I have to ask him about the mines again. Because, yeah, there's nothing else down here. Okay. Well, this is easy. It's like 5 minutes work and we're done. Hey there. Thanks for getting me back.
Oh, what do you want?
Alright, so about the mine. Thank you for rescuing Terras. I don't have anything to offer you except this raw glass, of course. Four of them.
Macera.
Which is heavy. I mean, it's worth a decent chunk of money, but... I don't need money, so I'm just gonna leave it. We like... He hands us this valuable raw glass and we just kind of like drop it on the floor and then disappear. Bye, guys. I believe I have this set in Wolverine Hall. I do. How convenient. Hey there. Took care of the mine. Sounds like everything went well. Here's your share of the contract. 250 gold, nice. How about an advancement? Ah! More orders? There's a creature loose in Berwyn, the trader's shop in Telmora. That's 200 septums forever takes care of this corpus stalker. There's also a contract for an outlaw nearby. Another 200 septums for whoever brings Rel's Tenem to justice. So let's get information on both. Go to Telmora. The corpus stalker was trapped in Berwyn, the trader's shop, last I heard. Oh man, anybody that grew up in Indiana? Anybody that grew up in Indiana and watched Svengoolie growing up? Berwyn. That's a joke from where I grew up. That's great, I love it. So tell me about Rel's. Rel's Tenem is a murderer who escaped from justice. He was last seen near Voss. While you're taking care of the corpus stalker, you might want to see if you can track him down as well. Sure. Last seen near Voss.
Greetings, Dunmer. What can I do for you?
For a second there, I almost thought he said Dunmer, not Dunmer. But then I'm like, surely they wouldn't have let something like that squeeze past QA. But I don't know. Now let's go outside and let's have a look at our map here. It's a Telmora. I'm also gonna quick save because this area has been crash prone on us. So we'll save just in case. Not M. I think Telmora is the one that's way up north, right? Yes, all right, and Voss is right there. All right, well, let's see. Telmora we can just take the boat to, which is what we'll do. As I get, this game's movement engine is so janky sometimes, I don't get it. You'd think I'd be used to getting stuck on things and stuff, but I'm not. That is, I would say, coming back to this, that is the biggest divergence from how I remember it. I don't remember getting stuck in stuff and just like the movement of this being generally janky, but I suppose prior to this Let's Play it had been quite a while since I last played this game seriously, so I suppose it's forgivable. Hey there, dude. Let us go to Telmora. I have a corpus stalker to kill, and then a bandit to kill. All right, so where is this thing at? The trader shop. Alright. M again for map. That's not what we need. Let's see here. Clothier, house, covenant. Okay, where's the. Now I don't want to know. Where's the trader shop? That worries me, because really, I would rather not have to go inside of these spires any more than I have to. But I dare say we may be required to do so.
Bothersome creature.
Man, I could kill you and everyone in this town, dude. Don't even taunt me. I don't even need my magic sword to friggin' go all... I don't even know. Judge Dredd on your ass? I don't know. Oh, here we go, Berwyn Trader. It was the one that I missed, apparently.
Go.
Okay, oh my god, terrain just, get, oh my god. These new faces are actually pretty good looking though, like surprisingly so. Like that looks decent. That looks decent. It's I would say like on par with Elder Scrolls Online, which I think, well, I guess Skyrim's faces are okay too. Where's my mouse? There's my mouse. Oblivion's faces are terrible. Just terrible. Hey there, I am here to get rid of your corpus stalker. We were able to trap it upstairs, but no one wants to risk disease by getting close to it. Normally Master Aaron would have taken care of it, but he's been so busy recently. Please hurry, it's wrecking my shop. Alright. I fear no disease. Wow, you've actually got it boxed in. If I had a bow or something... Yeah, this thing would be like literally no threat. I mean, I could throw some destruction magic at it, I suppose. Let's see here. Preferably something that isn't touch range. don't even know. Spark? There we go. My spells are so powerful, you guys, you don't even know. Oh my god. Sitting there blowing death magic at it for 20 minutes, or I just stab it in the head and it immediately goes down. Hey there. My friend, how may I be of service to you? Thanks for dispatching the Corpus Stalker. You obviously have great skill. Yeah, I don't mean to brag, but I am the Nerevarine. Just saying. Alright, so now we just want to go southwest down to Voss. And find this hooligan and put him to the sword. Oh god, water. No! Athalanthalas is one weakness. The sea. I don't know. Slaughterfish are kind of annoying, though. Anybody else? Ah! Nice trap, buddy. Oh my god, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Ah! Jesus. Okay, so Voss is just a little way down the road. This way. Okay, so we're now in Voss. We are looking for Rels Tenem. Alright, let's ask around a little bit. Hey there, boatman. Boatwoman. You know where Rels Tenem is? He's a thief and outlaw, stolen from some of the farmers in Voss. Check some of the local farmers. I'm sure they'll know something about him. Alright. So we want to check local farms. See, that's what I like about this game, is it's not like, you know, here's your map marker, go check out the Hengstacer farm. It's, no, just go check out a local farm. So now I get to poke around. It's like giving me reason to explore instead of just, you know, follow the breadcrumbs that they set out for me.
You waste your time. Go away.
Oh, you're fine. Can you tell me anything about Rels? Alright, so it's just, that's all everybody is going to tell me, I would gather. Here we go, Rels Tenem, he's a bandit. He stole some guar and some crops, and I don't know what else. I don't know where he is now, but the Ahe Musa might know. Check out the Ahe Musa camp north of here. Alright, so now we know that we're supposed to go to the Ahe Musa camp, which is decidedly north of here. It's funny how that works. But see, like, that's the kind of stuff that you don't really get in games anymore, you know? We're rewarded for asking around and talking to people, and like, that's great. I love that. It's just really cool, and it's kind of something that games really don't do anymore in favor of saving time writing dialogue and journal entries and just giving you the damn breadcrumbs instead. It was particularly like the most egregious example of it, and where it really started getting on my nerves, was actually Skyrim, where they're boasting, like, you know, all of these quests and stuff. And even coming from Oblivion, it's, you know, go to this cave and kill something, but they don't specify which caves, cause so that the game can actually just pick a random cave for you to go to, and then they throw you breadcrumbs. It's obnoxious as hell. Stranger, I believe you are the one I've seen in my dreams and— wait, what? Dreams and visions. The past 7 nights, I've had a dream of a white guar. I know this to be an animal sent by the gods to help my tribe. We've been suffering greatly from disease, and none of my magic will cure the ailment. Find this white guar for us, stranger. Let it lead you to a new hope for my people. Alright, I'll try to find it. I knew you were the one. Go now. I'm certain this animal will appear for you. In my vision, I saw it where the path was forked, where the rocks grow from the earth like fingers on a hand. That is just totally useless, but okay. Hey there. You know where Rels Tenem is? A man went to the cavern of Shalit on a small island southwest of Old Daedroth. He left at night with neither Messer nor Secunda could be seen. Perhaps this is the man you seek. To get there, cross the water to the first island north of camp. From that island, travel northwest to 2 more islands. On the second island's north side, the entrance to Shalit will be found on the water's edge in a small cove. Alright, so first island to the north, then 2 islands northwest. I am never gonna remember that. Unless it is, like, immediately right here. Why is the combat music? Oh, there's an Allet chasing after me. That's cute. And so is this the first island right here? I guess technically this is an island, even though it's, you know, 20 feet away from the other one. Cliff racers. All right, first island. Oh, come on. Screw you. And then two islands northwest. So, yeah, okay. So I assume that's probably this island, right? It's either this one or this one. I said it's probably this one, actually, now that I think on it. Because the other one is really more north than northwest. Oh, Lord. These Fighters Guild quests. Like I said, I should have probably done these earlier because these are certainly not really a challenge for a swordsman of my skill. I should be able to just kill my way to the top. Why can't I just start killing guild leaders and being like, well, I've taken his position, and then kill another one, and eventually we just work our way up, kill the guild master, and bam, we're the new guild master. I'm just saying. It would certainly make guild mastery more competitive, I'll give it that. Alright, so it should be like right over here. They said it's in a small cove. So we'll see. I'm not really seeing much of a cove. Yeah. Not seeing much in the way of a cove here. Unless this is actually part of the other island. Which I suppose could be, in which case this might be kind of a cove right here. Is this it? No, this is the Drethen Ancestral Tome. Sure. Why not? Assuming we've not been here before. Which, judging by the door being closed, I'm gonna go ahead and figure that we haven't. Hey there! Actually, give me your soul! I can use it to enchant my gear. Well, recharge my gear, I suppose. Tower shield, some bone meal, iron tanto, bone mold armor. Nothing I'm really too interested in. Oh, shillet! Alright, well, we found it. Cool. That was totally unintentional, but hey. Okay. We found what we're looking for. Apparently there is a secondary entrance. Rising force. Rising force. Oh, do we have to levitate to get up here? No. Why did they give us levitation potions? There's got to be a reason for that. What do we got? I know it's trapped. I just don't care. 250 gold. Nice. It looks like it nailed me with poison. Yes. Well, thankfully, we have Balyana's antidote. Yay! And I can cast it quite well, apparently. I don't know, they gave us those levitate potions, so that's like immediately putting me on edge that there's gonna be something in a ceiling somewhere with like an artifact in it. Crimson Cavalier mentioned that I actually missed I think he said it was a Dweemer Spear, a powerful Dweemer Spear. Back in that dungeon, the Dweemer Ruins, where that woman died in the lava. So thank you for mentioning that. I'm not going to go back and retrieve it, but know that it is there. So we have here, note to Gideon. Gideon, here's a blade for the new man. Send him ahead and we'll set up for his arrangements. Dinner's waiting, but not for you. Mervrele is sick again, so you've drawn sentry duty. Don't worry, you'll be getting a portion of his share. Stay alert. Bounty hunters are seeking us, but I feel fairly secure up here, Rels. Up here, huh? Up there, maybe. Let's see. Knock, knock! Oh. Are you who I'm looking for? No. You're the poor unlucky bastard that got sentry duty. Seriously? I'm impressed. I accidentally just cast levitate again. I meant to do this. There we go. Aha! My target. War Axe of Wounds. Cast on strike. See, like, this is a decent axe. It's got some damage on it. 1 to 10. It's not a ton, but, you know, it's not bad. The Rising Force Potion, Rising Force, Rising Force, Feather. rising force. All right, well, we've got a lot of levitation potions should we decide we need them. For whatever reason, they're collecting skirts. Small chest. Okay. Ooh, 400 gold. Nice. How long until he notices me? Scroll of healing. Large chest. With nothing too interesting in it. Alright. He's like, arr! And now he's paralyzed. And now he's dead. Who are you? You are Vilval Rilvani. Alright. You have nothing. That's another cast on strike weapon, but it's nothing that I'm too interested in. Swift swim, cure common disease. I need to get rid of some of these potions. I'm running around with an inventory full of junk potions that I really don't need. My god, where is this dude? I grow tired of hacking through your minions. Screw off, scamp. Just a bunch of coins. I see more chests though, which I'm okay with. Trapped, both locked. All right, well, let us take care of the traps first. Okay, so what is my lock picking? It's at 26, we might be able to pick these. We'll try. All right, that's actually surprising. I was gonna say I'm not particularly confident in our ability to get into these, but apparently we can. All right. Another 250 gold and 370 gold, some rubies, a few pearls, and an ebony war axe, which is actually kind of surprising. Dude, I've been working far harder than I should have had to kill you. Let's see, a steel broadsword of hewing and icicle. Sure. Cast on strike, 1 to 25. For us, like, this is actually a pretty good sword. It has, like, shit for charges, though, so it probably wouldn't be able to get too many swings off, but that's not bad. You know, I'm gonna take that. I like named weapons. That's kind of a weakness for me, I admit. Bunch of junk potions. Realm's Tenem Journal page. We strike a bargain with evil. While I'm uncomfortable and feel some unease with our current arrangement, I believe these warrens will serve us well for the time. Those who hope to destroy me must be of stout spirit and cunning mind, for if they simply forge ahead in these caves, they may meet a fate far worse than death. When we first discovered these caves and began our explorations, we were sure we had found refuge from our enemies. Little did we know as we pushed into the interior galleries what we would find. In the final chamber, we came upon the ruined portal to a vast tomb. At first, we were eager to chance upon some riches to fill our coffers, but instead we found ourselves within the nest of deadly creatures. By our wits and skill of arms, we were able to retreat from the dark lair. For a time, we sealed the entry, but the threat continued to gnaw at us. It was Gideon who conceived the plan to which we presented to those beings of darkness. In return for our right to dwell within these caves, we would provide sustenance for these creatures. To assist us in this venture, we have created a lure, a path for the bounty hunters and meddlesome folk to follow. The unwary will find themselves in the clutches of a black fate. Muvrela is very unhappy with the current conditions, and I'm finding myself concurring. This cannot come to a good end, but we must stay the course until a new safe hold can be found. Really? So there's some evils floating about in here, huh? Lessons of Vivek, nice. Block skill. Some chests, like there's just chests everywhere. Lady Binok's Words on Philosophy, which is a long blade book, which is a little late. Okay, so both of these chests are trapped. So we'll get those out of the way. Actually, they're not both trapped. All right, and there's actually a third chest that I had up until now not noticed. Security increased to 27. Okay, let's see what all we've got. Starting on the left, we have Iron Spark Slayer. We're not taking that. We have 2 gold, and we have 384 gold, a ruby, a pearl, 2 diamonds. We found Pokemon, guys, and a Daedric Wakizashi. I'm gonna take that. Add it to the stack, and a Marisian cuirass. Nice. All right, oh, and there's also this guy. Which is just some gems, nice. Honestly, this place is like a pretty good reward, just goodies-wise, I'm not complaining. Like, there's that ebony war axe, too, that I'm not gonna bother with, but is here. And so on. So, there's apparently some huge tomb in here, huh? I assume that's probably what's down this way? No, this takes us outside. Alright, so this is all just a ruse then to get the player to come down this way. Well, to get people to come down this way. We're like, oh, okay. You know, he's in this tomb. Alright, so we'll go into the tomb and kill the, like, one monster that was in the room. Oh, there's more. Alright. Just another room. I was gonna say, like, are you guys hostile or what? Oh, that's a vampire. Nice. Alright, so that's what they meant by sustenance then. Marara. With Marara's ring, worth 20. Holy shit. That is a very powerful ring. Reflect 20%, fortify acrobatics, resist normal weapons. Holy crap. I'm glad to have gotten that. Flowers, yams, and a chest. And in the chest is a soul gem. Alright. Another chest, we'll just pop it here. With a crappy ring. Potion, and that looks like everything. Alright, well, yeah, this was very lucrative. Let's go ahead and turn it in, and then I'm gonna call it an episode. Hey there, buddy. Let's see, we have taken care of the Corpus Stalker. 500, I thought he said it was only 200. Alright. And we've taken care of Rels. I've heard that Rels' tenant is dead. Good work. Here's your 200 septums for the contract. How about that advancement? Yes, I'm now the warder. Any new orders? I need someone to get a load of Sujama from the Duniri Caverns. Workers in the Addis Mine have been complaining that they're out of Sujama, and the Fighters Guild is responsible for supplying the Imperial Mines in Vvardenfell. Take this load of Sujama to Nelikar in the Duniri Caverns, southeast of Ghost Gate, between the Foyota Sinanum and the Foyota Ashurdan. Okay. I was gonna say, am I, like, that's gonna over-encumber me, isn't it? Naturally. Here, what I can do is, I'm sure I'll forget that I've left these things here, but I will leave a couple items just sitting on the table, and we'll get, because we'll be coming back to turn it in, ideally then that will help me remember, but I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, I hope you had a good time, and I will catch you all next time when the adventure continues. Until then.